إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير هدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة دلالة وكل دلالة في النار ثم أما بعد يا عباد الله إخوتي وأخواتي في الإسلام أوصيكم وإياي بالتقوى إن الله مع المتقين. O servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my brothers and my sisters in the deen of al-Islam, I exhort you and myself to strive for the quality of taqwa, for verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with those whom they possess this quality. Nahmudallah wa nashkuruhu ala ni'mat al-Islam. Indeed, brothers and sisters, we endeavor to establish the praise and the glorification of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as is the right of Allah, and to consistently manifest a sincere expression of shukr, of gratitude to Allah that He has guided us to this deen of al-Islam. A'zam ni'mah fi hayat al-insan al-hidayah. Indeed, the greatest blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can bestow upon a human being is the blessing of hidayah, guidance. Yahdi man yasha ila siratin mustaqim. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides whomsoever He pleases to the way that is straight. And brothers and sisters, we must always be cognizant of this reality that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us a great, great ni'mah, a great blessing that He has made us from the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. And even when it comes that Allah writes for us the test, and indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to write for each and every one of us the test in this life. And how do we meet the challenges of the test that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordained for us? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in His book, بَعْدَعُوذِ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, brothers and sisters, that O ye who believe, and whenever we hear this nida, whenever we hear this address in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, then according to the advice of Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, that we should train our ears for what is going to come after. And indeed, we know that every letter of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that it is endued with the guidance, yani the hikmah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But yet, when Allah chooses to address us specifically, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, then indeed we have to train our ears for what is going to follow. اِسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. That seek the help of Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us here a formula for seeking the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we recognize that it is part of our aqidah, part of our understanding, our faith, our iman, and establishment of the tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we always first and foremost seek the help of Allah. And indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it incumbent upon us to recite Surah Al-Fatiha in every rak'ah of every salah that we perform. And we say, Iyaka na'budu wa iyaka nasta'een. You alone we worship, and you alone we beseech for help. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, Ya ayyuhalladhina aminu sta'inu bisabri wa salah, inna allahama sabirin, that isti'ana is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That we seek help first and foremost from Allah. Indeed, we understand that no help can come for us except it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah gives us the formula for seeking that help. Bis-sabr was-salah. And the sabr, ya ikhwan wa akhwat, and that we usually define in the English language as patience. And in this sabr, it manifests itself in different ways. So we know, mashallah, that we all have on our hearts and our minds what has happened last week in New Zealand to our brothers and sisters there. Those whom they were martyred in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, indeed, after that particular ayah, وَلَا تَقُولُ لِمَنْ يُقْتَلُ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أَمْوَاتٍ بَلْ أَحْيَاءٍ وَلَكِنْ لَا تَشْعُرُونَ, that do not say about those whom they have been killed in the path of Allah that they are dead. On the contrary, they are alive. But the reality is that we don't understand the true nature of the life that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them. But make no mistake that they are the ones that they have been honored by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And truly, they were in the path of Allah, fi sabilillah, answering the call of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ba'da'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu idha nudiya lis-salati min yawm al-jum'ah fas'alu ila dhikrillah wa dhurbiya. O you who believe, when you are called to the salah on the day of Friday, hasten to the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and leave your worldly pursuits. Brothers and sisters, mashallah, they were in the Baytullah, in the masjid. They were answering the call of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and fulfilling the commandment of Allah, coming to Salat al-Jumu'ah. So indeed, they were called back to Allah on the best day, the day of Friday, in the best place, the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, doing the best amal, the salah, answering the call of Allah. So indeed, they are in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And inna Allah la yukfilu mi'ad. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never fails in his promise, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them what he has promised to the shuhada. And what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has informed us about, that they will be in the bodies of beautiful birds in the paradise with their houses suspended from the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah will give them the free roam of the paradise to go wherever they like. And when Allah asks them, is there anything else I can do for you? Then their reply will be, what? Ya Allah, you can do, what else can you do for us? And Allah will insist, what else can I do for you? And they will say that if you would do anything else for us, then give us our souls back in our bodies so that we can once again make the ultimate sacrifice for your pleasure. So brothers and sisters, mashallah, their test is complete. But we are the ones that we are after them. We are remaining here. We are dealing with the hatred. We are dealing with the ignorance. We are dealing with the prejudice. We are dealing with the enmity. We are dealing with all of these realities. That is the test that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written for us. But we know that the formula is to seek the help of Allah bi sabr wa salah, with patience and dua. Qala al-ulama rahimahullah wa hafizahumullah that dua in this ayah bimana, yani salah in this ayah bimana dua. And indeed, salah, it means dua. So we have to establish what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would have us establish. We have to be patient on the awamir of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the orders of Allah. That this is not a time for us to step back from being dutiful servants of Allah because of some anxiety, because of some fear, wa iyadhu billah. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us about the reality of the believers, about the reality of those whom they say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Those whom they said that when it was said to them, qala an-nas lahum inna an-nas qad jama'u lakum fakhshawhum fazadatuhum imana. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that those whom it was said to them that verily the people have gathered up against you, then you should be afraid of them. But what was the reply of the believers? What was the reality of the believers? That it only increased them in iman. وَقَالُوا حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ وَكِيلٌ. And they said that Allah is enough for us, that He is the best helper, the best protector. So brothers and sisters, this is the time to realize that we have to strengthen our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we have to come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and fulfilling the commandments of Allah. We have to be vigilant with ourselves, with our families, about being away from that which is displeasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we have to recognize and understand that indeed, whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed must certainly come to pass. That our job remains the same as it was before, and it will continue to be as long as Allah puts life in these bodies. And that is to establish the ibadah of Allah in accordance with the teaching, the practice of the Messenger alayhi wa salatu wa salam. So brothers and sisters, yes, our hearts are saddened. Our hearts are saddened that we think, when we think about our brothers and sisters whom they meant no harm to anyone, they're only coming out of their houses from their places of worship, and from with their children going to the house of Allah to fulfill the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then someone would come, wa ya'dhu billah, with that type of hatred, with that type of ignorance, with that type of arrogance to think that they have the right, wa ya'dhu billah. But in the end, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows. In the end, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not cause any of their actions to be of no benefit. They will get the full reward of everything that they did in this dunya, and Allah will increase them and write for them the shahada bi'idhnillah. So brothers and sisters, our question for us is, what do we do now? How do we establish the deen of Allah? This has always been the case amongst the believers. In the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, through the history of the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until the present day, there have always been those that they held or they hold in their heart this antagonism, this hatred for Islam, whether it is out of ignorance, whether it is out of arrogance, whether it is out of just blind hatred. Allah knows best. But that doesn't change our goal. That doesn't change who we are as the Ummah Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That doesn't change our job. That we are the ones whom we work to bring light to the society in which we live. We work to bring and show the nur of the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the environment that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed us in. Because for whatever reason, we may think that whatever country we immigrated from, or if we were born here, or whatever our purpose, business, or education, or profession that has brought us to here, this place, the reality is that we live in a society where we are less than 2% of the population. Less than 2% of the population in a country with over 330 some odd million people. How are these people going to come to know the beauty of the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How are they going to come to envelop themselves after the mercy of Allah in the guidance and the light of the deen of Allah, unless it is by the mercy of Allah and then the actions of the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the actions of those whom they follow, Khatim and Nabuwa, the seal of the prophethood, who was sent as rahmatul lil alameen, as a mercy for all the worlds. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he has been called back 1,400 some odd years ago, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written for him the test that he endured from the time that he received that first revelation in the cave until Fath al-Mecca and Hijrat al-Wida, until the opening of Mecca and the farewell pilgrimage of the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. Yes, they talked about him, they slandered him, they plotted to kill him, they did all of these things, but the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never once swerved in any iota from that message of Qul la ilaha illallah tuflihun. Say la ilaha illallah and gain success. He did not let the plots and plans of his enemies, he did not let, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the difficulty of the pursuits of this dunya, he did not let any of the political or economic situations and conditions of the time sway him from fulfilling that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had written upon him. And brothers and sisters, we are his ummah. We have to embrace who we are as the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We have to truly be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and recognize what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said. وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ الْآيَةِ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that when Allah, your Lord, has decreed that if indeed you are grateful to Allah, then Allah will increase you in his bounty. So brothers and sisters, this is the time for us to embrace a shukr, for us to stand up and be proud that Allah has blessed us to be Muslims. Proud in the sense that we know that regardless of whatever the enemies of Islam, they may, whatever plots and plans that they have, that indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala khairul makirin, that Allah is the best of planners. And that when we embrace who we are, then the only outcome of that is good. Khair in this dunya and khair in the akhirah. Good in this life and good in the next life. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept with the excellent acceptance the souls of those whom they were called back on the Friday past. And that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give the sabr and to their families, to their loved ones, to their extended families, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put in our hearts a true understanding of what it means to be a grateful servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa kullu qawli hadha wa astaghfiru Allah li wa lakum wa astaghfiruhu inna Allaha ghafurur rahim. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salam ala rasulillahi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa min wala. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم وبعد إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب يا الله يا غفور الرحيم يا السميع العليم يا ذا الجلال والإكرام إنك على كل شيء قدير المغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات ومسلمين ومسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات Ya Allah, be with us and help us and protect us in all of our endeavors, Ya Allah. Whatever you bestow, no one can hold back. Whatever you hold back, no one can bestow, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, give us the true iman in our hearts, Ya Allah. Increase us in love for you and for your prophet and for your deen and for striving in your cause, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, join our hearts together, Ya Allah, in unity, Ya Allah. And let us come together striving to establish our communities in a way that brings the light of Islam into the society in which we live, Ya Allah. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وأقيموا الصلاة